The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On earth, nations will be in anguish and perplexity at the roaring and tossing of the sea. People will faint from terror, apprehensive of what is coming on the world, for the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. He told them this parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. When they sprout leaves, you can see for yourself and know that summer is near. Even so, when you see these things happening, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. Be careful, or your hearts will be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and anxieties of life, and that day will close on you suddenly like a trap. For it will come on all those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. Take my lips, O Lord, and speak through them. Take our minds and think with them. Take our hearts and set them on fire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today is the beginning of the season of Advent. Advent is a season of anticipation. Advent is a season of hope and waiting. Advent is a time of preparation for the coming of Jesus Christ. It has been said, the extraordinary thing that is about to happen is not only by the extraordinary moment just before it happens. Advent is the name of that moment. The season of Advent invites us to consider sprucing up our inner selves in our souls, along with our homes and offices and churches, interior decorations that will go with all our exterior decorations. The Advent season is a season of decoration. In fact, most churches decorate designated decoration day, which we call the hanging of the green. During Advent, we spend a great deal of time decorating. We decorate our shops, our streets, our homes, trees, sometimes even ourselves with upbeat moves, a spring in our step, or even an unfamiliar smile to a stranger. There are two things to remember about all these decorations. First, they are temporary. The pencil, the trinkets, the lights come down and are stored away until the next year. All too often when this gambling goes with smile, the singing, the gate. Secondly, these decorations are exterior decorations. Things seen, not unseen. Things outside, not inside. Things visible, superficial, and artificial, not things of the spirit. The exterior decorations rely on now to get us in Christian spirit, often do remarkably little to alter the barren landscape of our souls. Then those reindeer, crayon snow, snow on the mantelpiece, reveal little about our hearts. Indeed, they themselves can contribute to a culture filled with people without inside, all exterior, all appearance, all image. By contrast, God's exterior always points to a defensive way to an interior reality. Luke's gospel reminds us that there will be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars, and the earth. Of all creation will reflect the spirit of the Creator's intention. Jesus shared with his disciples concerning the second coming. That's what they were saying, not only by an extraordinary moment before it happened. A strange text of the season of Advent, or is it? I don't think so. The birth of Christ encompasses much more than the Christmas story. Understanding this moves us into a realm that is far more than sentimentality. existence of God affects the whole universe, all eternity. The eternal God was incarnate in a man named Jesus. Jesus is God's servant. His word is flesh. It is the story of the love of God in humanity. Like all stories, it has a beginning, it will have an ending, a completion, and a climax. When Jesus came the first time, he came as a baby in a manger in an obscure village. Nobody much knew or cared except Mary and Joseph, and Shepherd, and the angels. He said he will come again a second time. God works purposefully to build his kingdom, a kingdom of justice, righteousness, and redemption. Too many people, good and bad, have never gone to the purpose of God. It is his doing, apart from all human calculations or designing. God is in charge. Remember, God is in charge. Jesus tells the disciples, there will be signs in sun and moon and stars upon the earth. There will be signs and circumstances reverberating throughout the entire universe. Signs meant for prophets to fear. Some fear a helper. He knocked and went quick. Show me a boy who does not know the meaning of fear, and I'll show you a boy who just beat up a lot. We're all a little jumpy. Being human means being insecure. But nothing is left. God is left. God's love will not be defeated. Nothing in this world can separate us from God's love. St. Paul, writing to the Christians in Rome, makes this affirmation. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, peril or sword. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loves us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principality, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creation, any other creature, shall be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. God never promised a life free from trial. What God promised was to be with us always. And through the grace of Jesus Christ, together, we open it victory. There is our hope. In the book of Genesis, we find the story of Noah. They had been endless days on the ark. Days of waiting and days of hope. In every direction, Noah could only see water. One day, in faith, he released a dove and searched for land. The Bible says the dove found no place to set his foot and return to the ark. Noah was put on the pole. He had to wait. He waited in faith and in hope. He sent out a dove a second time. He returned a string of freshly plucked olive trees from the sea. Noah could not see the land, but he knew it was there. It began to appear out of the watery waves. The work was over. As sure as God made new green apples, a new green world was nourished of the records of the old. In Christ, we find a freshly plucked olive leaf, pointing towards a day when all tragedy shall be overcome and all pain will be destroyed. There will be a new heaven and a new earth, and the first heaven and the first earth have passed away. A new kingdom will emerge. This is our faith. This is the mood that we find in the creation of Adam. Time began anew with the birth of Jesus Christ. The incarnation establishes new situations of humanity in the cosmos. God's action at Christmas was to be decisive, ultimate, and final. With the birth, death, and resurrection of Jesus, a whole new world has been created. When anyone is united with Christ, there is a new world. In the world where Christ rules and rules, where the Holy Spirit functions to keep life human, where love is indeed the rule. Our Lord says, look up and raise your head, because your redemption is drawing near. Frederick Buchner wrote of an everlasting Christmas story. And for myself, the longer I live, the more inclined I am to believe in miracles. I suspect that if you had been at the birth of Christ, we would have seen and heard things that would be hard to reconcile with modern science. satisfied with. The gospel letter is not only preaching, but fulfilling primarily the chapter first. They are interested in the significance of the meaning of them, of that birth. When a child is born, people who love that child are not interested primarily in the fact of the birth. Rather, we are interested in what the birth means to us, and for us, how the world will never be the same again. How our lives are changed with a new significance. When Jesus was born, the whole course of history was changed. The birth of Jesus into the darkness of the world made possible not except a new way of understanding life, but more importantly, a new way of living. Since his birth, countless different kinds of people, in countless different kinds of ways, have been filled with his feelings. They have been grasped by him, caught up in his life, and have found themselves in deep and type of ways healed and transformed in their relationship with Jesus. He was indeed the long-expected one, the Christ, wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. In this child is a power of God to bring life into this power of darkness, to make us whole, to give us a new kind of life to anyone who turns towards him. Even such as you and me, and he is indeed our salvation. He is the gospel of God. Apart from him, there is no gospel. This is the only truth that really matters. The truth of the story is found in the heart of the believer. It is being lived out in our lives daily. Take a symbol and give us your shelter as a nation. Break through our darkness with the way of the staff. Reach out for our loneliness and draw us into a family. Open our ears to the fire of the heaven. Take our pain and use it to bring birth, something new. May the promise, hope, peace, joy, and love of Christmas be yours in our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.